In previous lessons, we learned how to create center lines from the scratch. However, AutoCAD provides the appropriate tools for inserting center lines automatically in both circles and lines. I will activate the Annotate ribbon and take a look at the third panel, which is the Center Lines panel. The first tool is called CenterMarks and it applies to circles and arcs. I will activate the tool and click on the first circle. Notice that the tool does not deactivate automatically and I can keep placing CenterMarks to the circles. Once I have placed a CenterMark in each circle, I will press Escape to deactivate the command. Next, I will activate the Centerline tool, which can be found next to the CenterMark tool. This command requires to select two lines, so I will click on the left vertical of the rectangle and then on the right vertical and notice that the center line appeared automatically. This command, though, deactivates as soon as the center line is created. So I will press Enter to reactivate the center line tool again, and this time I will select the upper horizontal side of the rectangle and then the lower side. The tool deactivated automatically, and now all I have to do is to adjust the scale of these lines and marks. So at this point, I will select the two center lines and right-click to open the Properties palette. Notice that the line type is indeed center, but that is not visible in the model. To correct that, I will change the line type scale to 0.5. Notice that now the pattern looks better. Now we'll press Escape, and without closing the Properties palette, I will select all the center marks that I have placed in the circles. In the Geometry properties, we can find a variety of settings for those center marks. I will change the extension of every side to 2, and then I will press Escape to see the result. Now, the edges of the center marks do not intersect, and they are clearly visible. Similarly, I could have changed the start and end extensions of the center lines.